yourself, gotta make your connects. Never asking for someone's help, gotta get some respect. Please only focus on what he wrote. His will is beyond reach, and now it all unfolds. The skill of an artist. This is 20% skill, 80% gear. Be 100% clear, cause Rugby was ill. Would've thought he'd be the one that set the West in flames. Then I heard him wreck it with the crystal method, name of the game. Came back, dropped Megadeth, took him to church. I like Bleach, man. Why you had the stupidest verses? Dude, it's the truth. Now everybody giving them guest spots and stocks for the roof. I heard him with that stock.
This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5%, 15% pain, 100% reason to
sick, and he's spitting fire and mic. Got him out the dryer, he's hot. Found him in Fort Minor with top. Good afternoon, rugby fans. You are tuning in to the U Ottawa GGs versus the Bishops Gators.
Thank you so much for coming out today. Woo! Oh yeah, that's the energy, thank you. So after the events that transpired in 2020, the GG's women's rugby team took a look at themselves and decided to create a task force. They recognized the importance of honest conversation to further the growth and create a safe space on their team, on our campus, in our community. This game, the GG's Women's Rugby team has partnered with the Indigenous Resource Center and is committed to amplify Indigenous culture, celebrating Indigenous art, and to highlight the National Day of Truth and Reconciliation coming up next week. The team is dedicated to promoting awareness and encouraging each member of our community to get involved, volunteer your time or resources in support of and in solidarity with the Indigenous peoples. Miigwech.
Heureuse d'être ici avec vous aujourd'hui sur le beau territoire, sur les Anishinaabe Algonquin Sans Cité. My name is Tania Lalonde, and I am Métis Cree from the community of Buffalo Lake in Alberta, and I'm also the coordinator for the Mashkawozi Wogameg Indigenous Resource Center. And I'm here also as a residential school survivor. I would like to honor my great-grandparents, Sylvester and Maggie Powder, who attended the Lac La Biche Mission, and all residential school survivors, those who came home and those who did not. I'm so proud to be here today with my wonderful students. Where are you? Woo! And with my beautiful children, and to have my daughter Lexi here with me today. C'est un honneur de partager notre culture, de commémorer la journée de vérité et la réconciliation, et la journée de T-shirt orange. It is such an honor to be able to share our culture here with you today to commemorate the National Day for Truth and Reconciliation and Orange Shirt Day. The National Day for Truth and Reconciliation honors the children who never returned home and survivors of residential schools, as well as their families and their communities. Cette journée est l'occasion de rendre hommage aux enfants qui n'ont jamais pu retourner chez eux et aux survivantes des pensionnats ainsi qu'à leur famille et leur communauté. I am not French speaking, so. Orange Shirts Day was created by residential school survivor Phyllis Webstad and are worn each year on September 30th in recognition of the harm residential school systems did to the children's sense of self-esteem and well-being, and as an affirmation of our commitment to ensure that Everyone around us matters. I stand before you today, as I said, as an intergenerational survivor, and I've seen the impact of residential schools in my own family, and it has taken a lot of work to heal and to continue to heal. I'm so incredibly proud to be Indigenous and to see how powerful, beautiful, and resilient we are as a people, that despite every effort, we are here, we are thriving, and we are strong. Woo! I'm so thrilled to be joining you all today, along with the Varsity Women's Rugby team, to celebrate our enduring culture and to launch the start of this very important week and to remember together that every child matters.
Megwich, thank you very much. Digi Nation, let's ride!
Yeah!
Well, folks, hopefully you could hear that, but in case you didn't, the UOttawa Women's GG Rugby team has partnered with the Indigenous Resource Center in their effort to amplify Indigenous culture, celebrate Indigenous art, and to highlight the National Day of Truth and Reconciliation. And so we will have some nice performances at halftime, so stay tuned. Now, for the starting lineup for the Bishops Gators, number one, Maya Gordon. Number two, Mia Veneziano. Number three, Diana Egan Irvin. Your lock for the Bishops Gators today. Number four, Katie Locke. Number five, Francis Wheeler Hughes. Your back row today, Jaden Grace Goodsell. Mikaela Cola, who is also the captain today. And at number eight, Helen Stoney. At scrum half, Zenith Leroux. At fly half, Michelle Saint Laurent. Number 11, Annabelle Chamberlain Dusty. Scrum down. Mercedes takes it out. Pass it to Claire. Great breakthrough by the GGs, and they have the overlap. Oh, GG scrum half tackled at the sideline. Ball secured by the GGs. And that ball will be pushed through. Try given to the GGs. What a great way to start the game. I'll use this opportunity to announce your very own Gigi's lineup. At number one, we've got Debbie Oyetoran. Number two, Michaela, Don't Call Me Sweet, Sweeting. Number three, Talia, Pass Me the Bottle of Hennessy. Number four, Rachel Steele. Number five, Ketsa Kamba. Number six, Ritaj Abdullah. Number seven, Winnie Au. Number eight, Georgia Stewart. Your scrum half today, Julia Latremouille. Number 10, Claire Gallagher, who unfortunately has just missed the conversion. Number 11, Taylor Hendrick. Number 12, Sarah White. 13, Emma Wade. Your other winger today, Mercedes Cole. And of course, your fullback today is Aurora Bowie. That try was scored by Debbie Oyetoran. And the GGs will get ready for a kick return. The score is 5-0.
Nice kick!
That ball is recovered by Winnie, who will go for a run. She's taken down. Retouch breaking the line. Great running by the GGs. Ketza with a nice line break, and she is alone, taking into contact. There'll be a penalty here, diving over. Unfortunate for the GGs. And they are excited today. Nice and set on defense. The Gators will look to kick for some space. That ball stays in, recovered by the scrum half, who will counter kick into space. And she recovers her own kick. Talia taking it quick, will offload it. Great offloading by the GGs. Deborah taking into contact. And that ball is hammered through yet again. The GG's off to a fantastic start. Now, for those of you at home who don't know this, the GG is the first horse out of the gate. And folks, let me tell you, these GG's are right out of the gate with two tries. Claire will have her chance to redeem herself for the last kick. These GGs are absolutely disciplined. They are not celebrating. They are just ready for the next one. Claire Gallagher lining up for the kick. And it is good. Conversion scored by number 10, Claire Gallagher. And the score is 12-0. 5 minutes elapsed into this first half. And this will be a long game for the Bishop's Gators. That ball is caught by Claire Gallagher, who will go for a little run. With great stepping, and she's running along the sideline. Kick for space. Unfortunately, she cannot keep it in bounds, and that'll be a line out for the Gators. I'm joined here now live in the studio with Vanessa. That ball is won by the Gators. Nice aggressive run by the inside center. That ball is thrown wide, but it'll be knocked forward. Ref will play. We'll give a scrum down for the GGs. Pick and go. Mercedes on the wing, but the ref will call that back. He will call that a forward pass, unfortunately. Now, from this angle, obviously, it does not look forward, but we are not there, folks, and we will just have to bite our tongues.
That was a good scrum from the GGs before, so let's see another strong scrum here.
Let's see if they can steal the Gators' scrum. And that ball is knocked around inside. It'll be stolen by the GGs.
Well done.
That ball is sent wide. Claire Gallagher looking to have a run with it. She's got Mercedes on her wing, and she will pass it off. Mercedes unable to get clean ball, but Mercedes keeps going. She keeps her feet. Unfortunately, oh.
She wasn't held in that tackle.
Fortunately, Mercedes recovers the ball and knocks it forward for a, knocks it, or rather punches it in for a try. It is nice and sunny today in Ottawa at Man Anthony Field, but it is a windy one. And Claire will have the wind against her with a difficult kick on the side, but she is determined. I mean, Vanessa, if you're the Gators coach and you're in this huddle right now, what are you telling the girls?
I think I'd start off with just, you know, shake off the nerves. I know it's still early. It is windy. It's chilly. You know, the U Ottawa is a really strong team. Claire is a great converter, strong player on the field. So just shake off the nerves, get back into the skills that we've practiced all season, and just play our own game or play their own game.
That conversion is good. Thank you for that analysis, Vanessa. That conversion is made by Claire Gallagher, upping the score to 19 for the GGs. The fans very ecstatic for this game. Ketsia with an attempted offload. Unfortunately, it was knocked forward. And now there will be a scrum down for... the GGs. I guess it was knocked forward by the Gators.
I think a turnover gone wrong there.
Great play by Georgia Stewart to keep the ball in. The ref will not call anything. He will, however, call a yellow card for that high tackle. Unfortunately, Julia will be sin bin. And that is a devastating blow for the GGs. The Gators will have an opportunity now to make something happen. This could be their saving grace. Now, that was a good call on the high tackle. That's for sure. It was an absolutely high tackle. However, I don't think he made the right call on the scrum there. I think she took it out before it was out.
I agree. Yeah, the ball was still...
Yeah, Georgia Stewart did a great job at keeping it in there, mm-hmm. You know, and then the ref just completely ignored all that hard work she did. But what do I know? I'm just the commentator. Now, the ref will call that one back. Normally, the jumpers can't jump before the ball is thrown.
Good steal by the Gigi.
Winnie with a great steal and a fantastic run. She'll be taken down. Sarah White doing a great job at keeping her feet. Claire Gallagher filling in at scrum half for the sin bin, Julia. Is it Julia? Julia. Julia. And that ball is sent out of bounds. It'll be line out for the Gators, who are having a difficult time with their set pieces. That ball is disrupted by Talia. the GG's doing a fantastic job at setting their defensive line and committing to the tackles. Gators look for space, but that is recovered. Claire Gallagher going for a run, and she is fast. She will keep her feet. She's taken down at the 20-yard line.
Oh, great pick. Thank you, GGs.
And I believe that was their number four, Rachel Steele. Although it is hard to see from here, folks. I mean, these GG women, they are just so disciplined. They don't even celebrate. They are just ready, getting set, as if they're at the office.
Yeah,
it's just the day at work, and they are just, you know, doing their job, and that's what it is for them. It is just another day at the office.
It's a pretty great job. The wind's finally calmed down, so this should be a good kick for Claire. There we go.
And that conversion is made.
Conversion's good by Claire Gallagher, and I believe another try for Ketia Kamba.
My apologies, the try was for Ketia Kamba. Rachel Steele with a great play prior, however. Now, credit to these Gators. They don't have their hands on their hips yet. They are still looking to play some rugby. They drove down here all the way from Lennoxville. They are looking to, you know, have a great day. The despair has not hit them yet. So that is kudos to them. Nice kick by the Gators. It is recovered by Sarah White. And the Gators will attempt to take her down, but she will keep her feet. Claire with a nice box kick, and that is nice and high. And the Gators are taken down. Great chase by the number 15. And Sarah White will find touch there. The GG's obviously confident in their set pieces, so they will go for a line out here. And I don't blame them. They have been absolutely dominant this season, whether it be the scrum or the line out. Claire Gallagher with a nice wide pass. And that
great
is
drive.
Ketsa with a great run. She will go down, but not without taking several Gators with her. The Gators two on the ground. We never like to see this. She seems to be holding her head. And there will be a stoppage while the athletic therapists assess the player on the field.
If you look at the two teams, notice how the GGs are all huddled together collectively, but the Gators are a little bit more separated. You can tell that they're, I don't know, maybe angry with themselves a little bit for letting their defense kind of weaken and let the GGs get some good drives in there, good runs.
Yeah.
So hopefully they can clear their heads, get back to their game. It looks like their hunger
is fine. I think it's a mindset thing. Yeah. You know, it's. I mean, these GG women are, they're prepared for war. You know, they're grabbing cloth. It's like they're sisters in arms. The Gators look a little more lackadaisical, I'd say, a little bit more loose,
yeah,
a little bit more unfazed, perhaps, which I don't necessarily think is a good thing. And it shows really in the set pieces. You'll see. I mean, I would venture to guess this will be another dominant scrum for the GGs.
For sure.
Claire Gallagher acting as interim scrum half. Nice clean ball for the GGs. Claire Gallagher gets it to Sarah White. Great pass to Aurora, who will unfortunately lose it forward in contact. The Gators will secure the ball. And they will look to get something going. The Gators will look to find space, but it is recovered by Aurora. And that ball is sent out wide. Claire Gallagher, too fast. Unfortunately, not fast enough in this case. Claire finds the hole. She runs through. She's alone. A couple of nice steps, but she's taken down. The Gators doing a great job at disrupting that ruck. And they will call a penalty. That is a great play by the Gators to recover the ball. I believe that would be not releasing. Great run by Claire. Unfortunately, she was alone, and the GGs could not secure the ball. That ball finds touch, and we will have a line-out for the Gators at the 30-yard line, approximately. The score is 26-0 for the GGs, with approximately 20 minutes that have elapsed. Just under 20 minutes. That ball is won by the Gators. Great tackle by Winnie Yao. Great job at finding space. And that'll be a nice kick by the Gators. Aurora, unfortunately, unable to get there quick enough.
It takes a little bit of pressure off their shoulders. They're not in their 22 anymore. So it gives them a little bit of breathing room, hopefully.
Absolutely. Although, I would remind you that they're still up a player. And
that's
so
true.
This is
still gone.
I mean, generally, you always want position in a game of rugby. You go for the field position. But they got to take advantage while they still can, while they're up a full player. That ball is won by the GGs, and Georgia Stewart will go for a run. Sarah White looking for space, and she will. Great counter kick by the Gators, and that'll again go out at the 50-yard line. That ball is not straight. And the Gators will have an opportunity to go on the offensive. That ball is stolen by the GGs. Claire Gallagher with a nice high kick. It is recovered by the Gators, although not so cleanly. But they will look to have a go at it. Absolute aggression by these GG's forwards, especially the back row, doing a great job at putting in some work. Aurora Bowie looking to have a run with it. She will kick for space. It is recovered by the fullback. Nice step by the Gators, and she has found space. She will go for a run. Can she? Mercedes Cole doing a great job at catching up to her.
Unfortunate pass by the Gators, but it looks, it looks like they're keeping possession. I believe they still have it.
So I'm not sure what the call is, but there's a penalty against the GGs. I have not seen any hand signals by the ref, so it is hard to tell what he is calling.
I'm not sure, but Julia has re-entered.
We'll ask our in-house correspondent, Miami, if she knows what the penalty is for. So apparently coming in from the side. And the Gators will tap and go. It appears that Julia is back on the pitch and we are now at even strength. Great tackle by Talia Hennessy and Deborah Oyataran. That kick goes over Aurora's head, who will struggle to recover. Nice step, though, to avoid the contact. No! No! And the ref will call diving over. I am not sure about that call, but folks, I am not there. I'm just the lonely commentator here with my good friend, Vanessa.
There was a lot of people in that ruck, so I think he might have just gotten confused by what was happening. But let's see what the Gators can do with
now
this.
Now, the Gators will opt to go for points, I believe. It looks like a T. And I don't blame them. I think that's a great decision. Generally, if a team offers you free points, you go for it.
Absolutely.
Certainly, the deficit will not be cut by that much if she were to make this kick. But it's just a good message to send. You get points on the board. You get the ball back, which is...
Sure,
advantage.
And it'll definitely up their morale as well as a team.
Absolutely.
Just get some points on the board. That zero always stresses
course,
you out.
And that kick is good. On the Gators. And I believe that kick was made by Michelle Saint Laurent of the Gators. Low kick by Claire Gallagher. Gators will look to spread it wide.
Right to Claire's hands. She's
Claire Bear with a nice step. Another nice step. She's along the line. She will look for the offload. Great job at staying in bounds. Julia will get it out wide to Rachel Steele. Great play by Ketza to lure the defenders. That ball is passed out wide to Mercedes, who will... drive it in. Mercedes Benz drives it in for another try for the GGs.
Oh, that's a really great team try. I think at least, what, 6 or 7 players touched that ball?
Yeah.
At least, so.
Yeah, that is just some gorgeous rugby.
And that was the GG saying, yeah, we gave you 3 points, but here's
yeah,
five more for
exactly,
us.
Exactly, exactly. Clearly bitter about the 3 points. They came back with a vengeance. I mean, Claire Gallagher is doing a fantastic job at...
She's everywhere.
She's everywhere. She's extremely fast, extremely shifty, and hungry for the ball, hungry for some points. And the team really benefits from that.
Absolutely.
I mean, the look on these Gigi's faces, they don't even look happy. It seems like it's just not enough.
Yeah,
26 is just not enough. That kick is made by Claire Bear. Extending the lead to 30. The score being 33-3 for our very own New Ottawa Gigi's. The Gators having a bit of difficulty with their drop kicks. Hopefully they can get a nice high kick and give their support enough time to get there together, generate some defense maybe.
At the moment they have the wind in their favor, so hopefully that can add a bit of distance to their kick. See what happens.
Nice kick. Recovered by Claire Gallagher, who will look for space. These GGs set up beautifully in a flat defensive line with the back three ready for any counter kick that might come. The Gators having a hard time generating offense. Aurora will recover it and counter kick off the foot of the Gators nine, who will again counter kick and she will find the space. The Gators on the chase, Julia looking to pick it up. She'll pass it to Claire Gallagher, who will look to pass it off. Sarah White with a great offload. Ketsia coming down, but not without two Gators wrapped around her. Deborah with a great run, looking for the offload. Unfortunately, Talia unable to secure it. That ball is sent out wide. Mercedes looking to have another run. She is fast.
And she's gone. Just over the outside.
I wonder what the horsepower on that Benz is. The GG power, I should say. That is a fantastic try by Mercedes. The uncatchable. Claire Gallagher huffing and puffing a little bit, and I don't blame her. She is running all over the place.
Yeah.
I mean, when you have the ball and you know that no one can catch you, no one can touch you, what do you do? I would want to go for a run as well.
Absolutely. She did take a, I don't know if the camera caught it, she did take an extra second on the ground after that last tackle, but I think she's just maybe a little winded momentarily.
Yeah. But,
we set her up with a nice straight kick, so...
Great kick by Claire Gallagher.
And another try by number 14, Mercedes Cole.
The score is now 40-3 for the GGs with just under 10 minutes left in this first half.
And the conversion's good by Claire Gallagher.
I mean, these GGs are just set up, ready for the kick return. 40 is not enough for them. They will keep going. again, Claire Gallagher recovers the ball, and she will look to pass it to Sarah White, using her teammates now. That ball is fumbled forward. It'll be scrum for the Gators. Now, I tip my hat to the Gators. They are doing a good job at least attempting to get a defensive line, defensive structure. Unfortunately, they cannot seem to prevent the GGs from breaking the line, and that is very difficult to always be on the back foot.
Absolutely, and having knowing Jen Boyd, I know she speaks to her team a lot about communicating on the defensive line, and maybe the Gators just aren't that comfortable yet with clarifying who's going to be at what position, but it's still early-ish in the season. They still have time to
absolutely, improve. Absolutely, and they look young. I mean, Bishops usually does have a good team, so... Big scrum by the GGs, who will march it back and recover the ball. Georgia Stewart with a nice pick and go. She'll look for the offload to Julia, who will take it into contact. Sarah White finding the space.
Gators kicking that into touch, giving them a second of reprieve, but like you said earlier, the GGs are very comfortable in their set pieces. So.
Absolutely. And that is a great chase down by Taylor Hendrick, who will pressure the Gators enough to kick it out of bounds, giving the GGs the line-out throw here. It was a great kick by Sarah to find the space and a great chase. I mean, these GG's backs are just working in absolute unison today.
Absolutely.
Great communication. Georgia Stewart with the recover, and she will instruct her forwards where to maul. Ketsia with a nice branch off. Great offload. The GGs stopped at the 1 yard line, but they will get it done. That appeared to be Talia Hennessy with the try.
Another great team try. I mean, that the maul off the line out was really strong. Great picks afterwards.
Yeah. I mean, these ladies have great hands. They are able to get the ball wide. Any single one of these players appears to be able to pass the ball
absolutely
wide.
Super
at
talented.
Any given moment. And we can see here the men's team walking in slowly into the crowd, ready for their game following this one. The stadium here absolutely packed, and that kick is good for Claire.
Conversion is good, and I believe Talia Hennessy number 3 with a try.
That ball is recovered by Claire Gallagher, who will also go for a nice little run. These Gators doing a great job at coming off the line fast. Claire Gallagher looking for space. That ball will bounce and then find touch. Good decision. It'll be Gators lineout at the 45-yard line. Gigi's set up, ready for the lineout. Great lineout win by the Gators, who will now look to play it wide. Crash ball. She will look for space. Claire Gallagher with an unfortunate knock-on. However, I would almost venture to say that it was a better play to knock it on there than to let the ball go out.
For sure. I know this lineups get a little tiring sometimes. Yeah.
Well, the GG scrum has been absolutely dominant.
Absolutely.
They've been able to disrupt the Gators scrum.
The Gators do seem more confident now. After that last try, you could hear a lot more of the girls on the bench cheering on their teammates. So I think they have a bit more confidence going into play. Fortunately, they do turn over the ball, and it is now Gigi's possession.
Nice high kick by Julia. And that'll escape the hands of the Gators winger. That ball is recovered by Debbie, who will offload it to Georgia, who is taken down. Unfortunately, that ball was knocked forward into contact, and the ref will call a knock-on. Scrum down for the Gators. There seems to be a player down. I believe that is Deborah.
Once again, kind of look at the two teams. The GGs are collected. They're discussing whatever they need to talk about, but the Gators, a lot of them have their hands on their hip. The backs aren't with the rest of their forwards. They're just a little scattered.
Now, Deborah will rejoin the huddle, although she does look a little beat up with a slight limp. However, that is just pure grit. She does not want to leave this game. And she's having a fantastic game.
For sure. And just a minute till half, you know, she can rest, rest then, come back stronger. So
absolutely.
She'll power through.
Gigi's with an absolutely dominant scrum. And this will be now a scrum down for the Gigi's at the 5-yard line. It was taken into the zone by the Gators, and then the ball was touched down in the end zone by the Gators, which it results in a 5-meter scrum. And a nice pick and go with a quick try to end off this first half. I believe by Talia Hennessy. Difficult to see from this angle. Claire will once again line up for the conversion.
clean conversion. It's another 2 points for the GGs. Yeah.
Are you hungry, thirsty, or a little bit of both? Our good friend,
and that'll be halftime.
I've got you covered with Asian-style tacos and some of
the score, 54-3 for the GGs. Now, we do have a special halftime show today, so please stay tuned. Once again, after events that transpired in 2020, the GG's women's rugby team took a look at themselves and decided to create a task force. They recognized the importance of honest conversations to further their growth and create safe spaces on their team, on our campus, and in our community. This game, the GG's women's rugby team has partnered with the Indigenous Resource Center and is committed to amplifying Indigenous culture, celebrating Indigenous art, and to highlight the National Day of Truth and Reconciliation.
And now I would like to introduce
the team is dedicated to promoating awareness and encouraging each member of our community to get involved, volunteer your time or resources in support of and in solidarity with the Indigenous peoples.
Inuit women as a friendly game and competition. It is done by imitating sounds from our natural environment. One person will make a sound, and the next person has to follow immediately after. The leader switches the sound and the rhythm in order to try to make the follower make a mistake. Please welcome Tracy and Annie.
Let's make some noise.
Woo!
Clear enemy.
Up next, we have Selena, Kata, Neptulin, first island in Ontario. An accomplished hoop dancer, she has won numerous championships and has been ranked as one of the top hoop dancers in Canada, the US, and ranked amongst the top in the World Hoop Championships. She is also a teacher at the Urban Aboriginal Alternative High School and an athlete who has won 7 medals in athletics and canoeing in the Masters Indigenous Games this past summer. Mikuchlina. Yes. Mikuchlina, for sharing your talents with us today. Please welcome her.
Thank you.
the GG's women's rugby team, we would like to express our most sincere gratitude to Selena, Annie, and Tracy for these incredibly powerful performances. Today's performances would not have been possible without the support of the Indigenous Resource Center and the tremendous work of Tanya Lalonde and Darren Sutherland. We invite our fans to join the Gigi's Women's Rugby team and volunteer your time or resources in support of the Indigenous Resource Center and in solidarity with the Indigenous peoples.
All right, welcome back, everybody. Gators are about to start the second half. Nice long kick.
That ball is nice and secured. Julia doing a great job trying to. The ref calls that out. I'm unsure as to what his
reasoning was.
Reasoning is, I guess he felt it didn't come out quick enough.
So we're setting up for a Gators lineout. Hopefully over halftime they got to recuperate. Let's see a nice clean ball. The wind is not in their favor at the moment, so we'll see how that goes. It is stolen by the GGs. Julia playing it out. Oh, messy ball out to 1-1, but Claire does recover it and is gone down the wing. Mercedes is there. Beautiful offload, and she's gone like the wind straight into the try zone. Just gonna set Claire up nice with a nice touch right under the uprights. This is a great start for them in the second half.
All right, Vanessa, what happened there?
It was an unfortunate, messy play by the Gators that the GGs just easily scooped up and took advantage of. Really, really great teamwork, just knowing yourself, knowing your teammates.
They've wasted no time in this second half.
Absolutely not.
3 minutes, just under 3 minutes have elapsed.
Nice way to sandwich the halftime. Try at the end of the first. Try at the beginning of the second.
Yeah. Well, exactly. Pick up right where they left off.
Exactly.
Now, from what I can tell, I don't see any substitutions at this point in time. But we will keep you posted. I can imagine Jen Boyd will want to give her bench players some reps, some opportunities to touch the ball for when they do play a team that gives them a little bit more of a challenge.
Kickoff recovered really well with a great run. An unfortunate penalty for the GGs. Let's see if the Gators can capitalize on this.
Diving over was the call. I mean, when you have a team this dominant, the ref is going to be a little bit stricter.
For sure.
Just to know, you know, ensure that... that they are playing proper rugby. But he is at least consistent and will penalize the Gators. Julia doing a great job offloading to Ketsa. Nice high kick by Claire. That ball is chased down. Sarah White with a great tackle. Pick and go by the Gators. They will not make any yards on that play. Another pick and go.
Yeah, the GG's defense is so strong. They weren't letting the Gators any leeway there. And they get the penalty.
I mean, this ref is... well, he's interesting,
to say the least.
To say the least. I don't know what he's calling. But there will be a penalty, and that ball is kicked out of bounds for touch. It'll be a GG's lineout. I mean, there's some great talent in this GG's back line, and they can get it wide. Nice line-out win. That ball will be mauled. Georgia Stewart in the middle, leading the pack. And Ketsa will branch off with Talia in support. She will finally be taken down.
That was a really great drive by the GGs. I think they made 15, 20 yards.
Yeah.
One mall.
Sarah White taking a contact on a nice crash ball. Julia will get it to Talia, who will run sideways, but she will make tons of yards there. Nice presentation. Julia giving it to Claire, and Taylor Hendrick will punch it in. The Gators' defense a little slow to get organized there, and Taylor will take it in against... two Gators. I mean, you can now start to sort of see the despair on the Gators' faces. Hands on the hips, heads down.
Definitely frustrated.
Absolutely. And these GGs are still hungry for yet more points. The men's team warming up in the end zone, preparing for their match. The GG's mascot attempting to awaken the crowd. Saturday is a rugby day, as you all well know. That kick is missed left by Claire.
Great connection, just a little bit off.
Good distance. Yeah, exactly. Just not quite lined up.
She doesn't even look phased, though. Neither do the rest of the GGs.
Of course not. Although I'm sure deep down, I think she's probably telling
she's
herself.
Thinking about
I mean,
it.
When you're as elite of an athlete as Claire, it doesn't matter how many you've gotten. You always want
a
couple
more. She's going for a record.
Well, yeah. Well, she knows once they face off against a better team, it's
every point
she won't have
count.
The opportunity to miss those kicks.
Exactly.
So she looks just as disciplined as ever. That's for sure. She's having a phenomenal game, as are the rest of the GGs. The score is 66-3, with just over 30 minutes left to go in this second half. Nice high and deep kick by the Gators. It is caught by Rachel, who will go for a nice run. She will not find the offload. Ketsia going into contact. The ref will call an interference. I'm not sure I agree with that call. There has to be an attempt to, or rather, there has to be an opportunity to make the tackle. I don't know if that Gator was anywhere near the tackle. But nonetheless, the ref will call it as it is, and we will have a penalty against the GGs at their 45-yard line. And there will be a Bishop Gator being helped off the field. Again, we never like to see that. Ketsa doing a great job at holding that ball up, and that'll be a maul. The GGs will look to counterattack. Great job by Ketsa. The Gators unable to get the maul going, and that'll, of course, be GG's ball scrum down. And they are first to set. This is just a disciplined GG's team.
Of a messy scrum. I think it started well for the GG, so let's see how they're going to reset. There's a bit of an early drive from the Gators, so the ref's just going to give them a quick chat, and then we'll reset one more time. Easy drive for the GGs. Georgia out with no problems. Julia on the run. She has assistance.
Ooh.
Oh, unfortunate fumble by Claire that the Gators did pick up.
Ooh. and they will play their advantage. I don't know why the ref calls that back, but...
Neither do I. They had possession.
Yeah.
Maybe he just wants them to keep practicing their scrum. Let's see how this goes.
Yeah, you know what? I'm pretty disappointed with that call. I mean, a team gets the advantage. They recovered the ball back. You know, let them play. Let the girls play.
At least one more phase before calling
it. Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's... And especially now to put them in the scrum where they have not had any advantage at all. I would have let them play, but, you know.
Yeah, see another
Gators
big drive.
Will try and get that out, and it's taken out.
Julia immediately there to tackle.
Great tackle by the scrum half. The Gators looking to generate some offense, doing a good job at securing their rucks. And there will be an advantage for the Gators. And that'll be kicked out.
Good pressure on the kick, but the Gators did have the advantage, so they'll regain possession.
Gigi's doing a good job at getting set up. And that ball is kicked out into the stands. It'll be a lineout for the Gators with just over 26 minutes left in this second half. The GG's cardio unparalleled.
Absolutely. They don't look tired at all?
No. Tempted trick play by the Gators. Unfortunately, it'll be recovered by the GGs.
And it will be
not
called back.
Not five, free kick is the call. Julia will take it quick to Sarah, who will pass it out wide. Aurora with a nice run. Unfortunately, she does not find her teammates, and that ball is taken down at the 20-yard line. They will continue to play at flow side. Claire with a nice grubber. It's recovered by the Gators. And they will call, I'm guessing, an offside there against the GGs. Gators will take it quick. And a nice crash ball by the Gators. That ball is out.
The Gators were not there to support their teammates.
I feel like there should have still been an advantage for the Gators. But what do I know? Talia refusing to go down. She will take extra yards. Claire with a nice breakthrough and a nice offload to Aurora, who will get in there, and she will touch it down. Another try for the Ottawa GGs by Aurora Bowie. Great footwork by Claire Gallagher to just stay on her feet.
Yeah, just dancing.
And with that little
extra
step, she's able to get some space and offload it to Aurora, who is coming in hot with speed. Jen Boyd, the head coach, with her arms crossed. She runs a tight ship, and she is not happy until she gets the championship. Nothing less. And you can see she is still serious as ever. But I think it shows in the discipline of the GGs. It translates well to them.
Absolutely.
Who are always ready and always set and
always
looking for more. And they have the score to back it up. The score right now is 71-3 for the GGs. And there will be some substitutions, which we will try and tell you all in a moment.
I believe Kaylee McMillan has subbed on. Wearing jersey
we
number 20.
Tian at 21, number 21 in the front row. Leia Stiles, number 19, filling in at lock, I believe. Great offload by Claire. Great feet by Julia,
who will keep her feet.
She is relentless. Even after getting pulled by her hair, she said, not today. Kaylee McMillan with a nice run.
Big stiff arm.
Sophie McDonald in as well.
Yeah, these subs were a great choice. Yeah. They're just
They're fighting for positions here, right? They want to be the ones to get in for those 60 minutes. So they are coming out hot. And a great coaching decision by Jen. Put them all at once. Let them develop their chemistry together. And really get some fresh legs. There don't appear to be any substitutions in the backs. Although I do not see Mercedes in the lineup at this time. And that ball is taken in once again past the try line.
I think that try was done by Emma Wade. Nice drive forward, kept pushing forward, pushed it down past the line.
Anna Dodge in the lineup as well. And Annalise Way. And yet another conversion for Claire Gallagher. Her umpteenth of the day. Annalise doing a great job at staying in bounds. She will be taken down. Ball secured by the Gigi's. Great run by Sophie.
Right down the middle.
And she is fast. She will. Unfortunately, she will be taken down at the 10-yard line. And a nice pass by Julia to Sarah White, who will punch it in. I mean, what's difficult about playing these GGs is that even when they get tackled, they always make yards. I've not seen them get driven back once this game, and it just shows Sarah White able to find those extra yards and get the try. It is getting a little cool, the wind picking up again, but it is sunny. A great day for a game of rugby.
Absolutely.
My apologies, folks. Apparently, that ball is called back, and there will be a dropout of the end zone. I guess it was held up or knocked on. I'm not really sure.
I didn't see the ref call anything, but that was an unfortunate clear by the Gators that the.
Yeah. Gigi's well, they now have the wind against them.
Yeah.
Now this ref will have a chat with both teams for who knows what reason. Maybe to assert his dominance as the arbiter of this match.
Yeah, for me, it looks pretty frustrated. I'm not sure what he's talking to them about, but he's definitely not happy with either team.
Yeah. Well, when you live your whole life dreaming of going pro rugby, you know, reffing the pros, and then you end up at the RSEC level, I can imagine there could be some frustration. But watching these GGs play, I would say
it's gotta be a good time.
You're just about there. I mean, this is some great rugby by our very own GGs. The GGs a little slower now to get set. Perhaps unsure about their formation. And with all the subs, I don't blame them. That ball is recovered.
Still able to take advantage and keep possession. Two nice wide passes out to where there's no defenders present. Easy try
by Emma Wade. And they will redeem themselves.
Yeah, there's no doubts about this one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I guess I spoke too soon again. It seems there were plenty of doubts on this one.
Yeah. Our apologies. Let's
I just hope
scrum.
This ref is not going to stick around for the men's game.
Yeah.
That's for sure. And there will be a scrum down for the Gators. And now he will call broken arm penalty again. Oh, he will call that one for chatter. The Gators, I'm not sure they're aware they should not be kicking this straight out. And they don't. And that ball is recovered by Taylor Hendrick, who will look to spread it wide to Sarah White, who has support on the side, but she will take
it
into contact. The touch judge calling that a knock forward.
I think the GGs were just so lucky to, or so excited to get their hands on the ball.
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, they have not lowered the intensity once this game. Did we miss any other substitutions? Let's see. It seems number 25, Becca, is in for the scrum half, Julia. And she will get that off to Sarah White, who will go in for the crash ball. The ref calling penalty advantage. Tons of Gators on the floor. And this game has devolved a little bit. The GG's unable to send it out wide. The ref will call back the penalty for offsides, and the Gators will have to get set. Sarah White looking to kick for some space.
Good kick by Sarah. I believe they're going to have a line out at the 7-yard line. Your take.
We also have Ella Blythe in the back line. So tons of substitutions. I hope I've called everyone's name. And for those fans watching, supporting some of these players, I hope you can recognize them yourselves as well.
There's a lot of phases there in about a 5-foot period, but the ref is calling it back.
Sarah White will look to take it quick. She will dish it off to Emma Wade, who will go down at the 1-yard line. The G's will look to secure this ball and fight it in, which they do. And that try is awarded to Kaylee McMillan.
Perfect.
And a nice conversion made, this time by Taylor Hendrick.
Kaylee McMillan. And the conversion is good by Taylor Hendricks.
The score, 85 for the GGs. 2-3 for the Gators with just over 10 minutes left in this second half. And the Gators looking just to end this game as quickly as possible.
Meanwhile, I'm sure the GGs are looking for triple digits.
Absolutely. I mean, you could see them set up for the kick, all their fresh subs. They're hungry. They didn't get to enjoy all that, you know, the slaughter from the first half of the game. Great run by Aurora Bowie, although she will be taken down by the Gators. Sarah White will kick for space. That ball will be caught by the Gators. Great defensive line by the GGs.
Unfortunate knock on. I think the Gators were excited for that break.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now with Talia Hennessy and Debbie Oye Toran out of the pack, they do lose a bit of power, but it seems that they can manage. Although the ref will now call broken arm penalty again, unclear what the call is for. Thank you. The Gators will pick and go. Great tackle by Sophie McDonald. That ball is knocked forward into contact by the Gators, and it is recovered by the Gigi's, who will now look to turn on the Jets on the offensive. Sophie going into contact. Great hands by Aurora Bowie, who will keep it going. And that ball is stolen by the Gators with a great poach.
Huge tackle by the GGs.
I believe that was Leia Stiles with an absolutely crushing hit. And they will call offside against the GGs, penalty for the Gators at the 30-yard line approximately. 35-yard line. And another Gators player on the ground. These Gigi's have such power and aggression. It would not be fun to play against them, that's for sure.
Having experienced that, I can concur. Year after year, they just get stronger.
Great run by the Gators 7.
Massive tackle by Anna Dodge.
One of the big issues by this Gators team is that they've been unable to get clean passes. A lot of the times the girls are catching the ball on the standstill or they're catching the ball behind them. And that's really causing them to slow down their runs.
Absolutely.
Aurora with a great run, and she'll find space, and she will find all the space. Unable to be chased down by the Gators, she will touch that down. Great individual effort by Aurora Bowie. And that conversion is missed, unfortunately, to the right by Taylor Hendricks. The score, 90-3 for the GGs.
Try scored by number 15, Aurora Bowie.
Four minutes left in the game, and the Gators are taking their sweet time to reset for this play.
I mean, these GGs are set. These fresh legs want another run. They want to go for that triple-digit score.
Nice kickoff.
Aurora again with a great run. Anna Dodge with a great run. She refuses to go down. Leia Stiles with a fake. and she will truck through the Gators and touch it down right between the posts. The score now 95-3, and they will look to convert. I mean, when you're this close, I can imagine the GGs are looking to get one more just to get that triple digit.
Absolutely.
They've got enough time. I mean, they can do it. That conversion is made.
Which gives the GGs just 3 points from triple digits. They're going to hope play resumes quickly.
Yeah. Well, the Jumbotron clock may not be exact to the ref's watch.
True.
And so there may be less than a minute left here. Nonetheless, this was a phenomenal game by the GGs and a great battle by both teams. Low kick by the Gators, recovered by Sophie, who will find space. She will put the Gators on their back foot. Great offload by Anna Dodge to Leia Stiles, who once again breaks the line. Sarah White with a nice up and over. And that'll be chased down by the GGs.
And recovered by Sarah.
Sarah White, who will get the try. Between the posts. And she will get it done for her team. 80 minutes of fantastic play. And the GGs accomplished what some may have thought was impossible. They have put up triple digits in this match. And if they can make this conversion, they will increase the deficit to triple digits as well. That conversion is good, and that is the game, folks. Fans and friends alike, thank you so much for tuning in. Be well, enjoy the rest of your Saturday, and be sure to tune in for the men's game coming up in just a few minutes.